So, all right, so here we go. The name of the talk is the Tao of Abundance. This song was Water by Daniel Namod. We will be talking about why you need to trust the universe, Taoism. The Tao of Abundance is actually a book, and so I will be pulling from that quite a bit. We will be talking about scripture and the need to trust. We will be talking about nine life lessons from the Tao Te Ching. So, abundance is the ability to feel at peace in solid relationship with God, who provides all of the strength and all of the answers. In Taoism, it is called the way, the ability to flow, trusting that all of the answers will be provided, the ability to stay grounded and to live in the moment. In many ways, abundance is intimately connected with trusting the universe. In understanding you already have everything that you need, and that the flow of abundance is the nature of the world. So, we're going to start with why you need to trust the universe. This is a talk that was given by Jason Gregory. Jason Gregory, I've referred to many times before. He is a scholar who studies Eastern religions mostly, does some comparative analysis, but he did do a talk on Taoism. And he says that we can feel truly abundant when we are at peace. And we are at peace when we trust the universe and stop trying to control. The unity we seek between us and the universe can never come from an intellectual understanding. This only comes from what he calls a liberated mind. The essence of both consciousness and the universe is that everything is connected and ultimately one consciousness, like space, emptiness, and vastness, contains the whole universe. It is necessary that we first get out of the intellectual process of trying to define the universe. Letting go of the need to explain requires trusting in the universe. He says, quote, "The truth and reality of the universe and consciousness are one, but trust is where oneness is realized within our own being. When you trust the universe, you become one with it. When we let go of control, we give the power and the virtue over to the Tao. The relation of trust and oneness is the principle of living Wu Wei." You and I have talked about Wu Wei quite a bit, and so we'll be talking about that a little bit as well. Going with the flow. So think the water song. I found the water song, and it was just perfect for this talk. Lao Tzu taught us not to intellectualize oneness, but instead to feel it and to know. The ancient sages teach how finding God within, not the intellectual pursuit of God, but the innate experience of God, you can come to understand how the oneness is the only reality. So the Latin word religare, the root of the word religion, and the Sanskrit word yuj is the root of the word yoga. And both words describe the union with God that can only be found within. Once we stop trying to explain and define and control, the peace within knows how to trust, because that is the acknowledgement of the unity, the feeling of oneness within ourselves. We never need to be disturbed by the fluctuation of life in the outside world. The only way to feel safe and stop trying to control is to trust in a way that is not dependent on our thinking mind. Trust is the validation that the universe is one and that you do belong. Overemphasis on intellectualizing blocks our ability to feel that oneness. Religion attempts to intellectualize God. Philosophy attempts to intellectualize the universe. Psychology attempts to intellectualize the mind. And with all this, we destroy the world in trying to give it meaning from our puny intellects. That's a direct quote from the book. Taoism and Buddhism seek to discourage any intellectual pursuit of understanding oneness, because they teach trust in the self and life, and that leads to peace and unity with the universe. You must step out of all of our learning to have an experience of letting go and trusting. And that sense of unity with the universe, that peace that it brings, is what is true abundance. It has nothing to do with physical, tangible objects, nothing to do with having or accomplishing or theory. It only has to do with a sense of completeness and wholeness and peace. The peace that resides in the unity of trust allows the individual to harmonize with the world. This not only brings the light of Tao into the world, but also guides and helps the individual along their journey through life. So, as I said, the Tao of Abundance is a book. I highly recommend it. It is written by Lawrence Bolt. I'll leave all of the links and all of the information when I send it out. He also wrote Zen and the Art of Making a Living and How to Find the Work You Love. He says that abundance is a state of mind, a feeling of enough and to spare. It is a state of being. It is from the Latin word abunda, rei, which means to overflow. Wealth is from the word wella, rei, which means well-being. Prosperity is from prospera, which means to render fortunate, and rich is from riche, which means strong and powerful. To live in abundance and be fully alive, you need to be free of any sense of lack or desperation. It is the art of knowing how to live, to have a deeper experience of abundance than can be realized by the mere accumulation of goods or by amassing or impressing a balance sheet. Working towards experiencing that deeper state of psychological abundance is relinquishing the attachment to social status or excessive material consumption. The fundamental principle of Tao of Abundance is the universe is you and it is for you. You need to put yourself in accord with the way of the universe. What is required is that you become aware of the inner process through which you create an experience of lack or struggle and refrain from doing it. So the only way you can move forward with building an abundance mentality is by acknowledging and understanding all of the things that you have put in the way of feeling that. The feelings of abundance and gratitude are natural. You need to become aware of how we are resisting this natural state. You need to accept responsibility for creating your own experience of abundance or lack. Modern culture promotes a lack of consciousness by things that we don't need or want because we are convinced that we are somehow lacking or inferior without them. The awareness of social dynamics promotes a consciousness of lack, plus the ego binds us to this. We'll be talking a little bit about the ego a little bit more in a minute. Consciousness gives us the ability to change and empower ourselves. The system is the ego. Freeing ourselves from this is our primary concern. The answer is the Tao feeling of abundance. We should not shun money. Good can be done by having it. Suffering can be avoided. It can also give a measure of freedom to us from control of others when we have some money. The Taoist values freedom and preserving dignity of the human spirit, being able to affirm and follow your own path. Money is important in determining the time we have to enjoy our life and the power and the freedom that we have. So when you're talking about the role of money in your life, you need to ask yourself two questions. One, how much do you need? And two, what is it going to cost you to get it? Money should never cost you your soul, your relationship, your dignity, your health, your intelligence, or your joy. How much you need falls into two categories. The first is the material to keep your body and soul together. And the second is the need related to the social status and position. Taoist Master Yang Chu teaches us we should listen to our own voices and follow our own hearts and not follow other people's rules or live to please others. In a recent study, 48% of the male executives felt that their lives were empty and meaningless, despite that they had enormous amounts of wealth. So there are eight Taoist principles we're going to talk about that provide powerful keys to embracing and integrating a psychology of abundance. But first, as I said, we must deal with that sense of alienation and separation that constitute the psychology of lack. I will be doing a whole talk, it may even be next week, on the psychology of lack and how we fall into the trap of feeling that we're not enough and we don't have enough. The psychology of lack means that you have a sense of struggle all the time, a lack of ease, a lack of energy, feeling of powerlessness and blocked expression, a lack of harmony and connection in relationships, a lack of time to be and to grow and to relate, a lack of opportunity to fully appreciate and celebrate the beauty in life. The road to total abundance requires three primary tasks. Number one, recognize the inner and outer forces that conspire to make us believe in scarcity and to have a feeling of lack. Number two, cultivate a spirit of abundance in our lives, celebrating the gift of life with joy and thanksgiving. And number three, focus your thoughts and your actions on things that bring connection with life. Move with the flow of the Tao. Come from a spirit of abundance, and you will attract greater abundance. As we move in the world from a spirit of abundance, become a liberating and empowering force in the lives of those with whom we interact. Unite in the spirit of abundance and you will create new ways of relating based on cooperation rather than competition. As envy, greed, and competition flow from wrath, compassion, service, and cooperation flow from the spirit of abundance. So here are the eight principles of abundant living. Number one, the nameless Tao, Wu Ming, to recognize the unity of all things. Number two, nature, the receptivity of the Tao, Chu Jan, learning to receive opens the door to the greatest good. Number three, ease, Wu Wei, following the path of least resistance. Number four, flow, Qi, the circulating the energy in your life strengthens health, deepens relationships, and generates wealth. Number five, power, Te, honoring your innate dignity, actualizing your inborn abilities. Number six, harmony, Yin Yang, balancing the yin and yang eliminates stress and brings peace of mind. Number seven, leisure, Zhen, taking time to be, to grow, and to nurture your relationships. And number eight, beauty, Li, achieving destiny is the matter of trusting and embracing the organic patterns of life. So if we contrast the way of the Tao with the way of the ego, number one is the unity of the Tao versus the separation of the ego, which produces lack of connection and alienation. Number two, the receptivity of the Tao versus the attachments of the ego, which is lack of spontaneity and inspiration. Number three, the ease of the Tao versus the struggle of the ego, the lack of ease, the tension, and the stress. Number four, the flow and joy versus the resentment of the ego, lack of energy, and lack of zest for life. Number five, the dignity of the Tao versus craving for the approval of the ego, the lack of the power and inner direction. Number six, the harmony of the Tao versus the competition, hostility of the ego, the lack of inner and outer peace and harmony. Number seven, the leisure of the Tao versus the greed of the ego. And number eight, the beauty of Tao versus the chaos of the ego and the lack of meaning. So those are actually chapters in the book. Each one of those eight things is a chapter in the book. He asks us to strike a balance between the material and spiritual wealth and have a new definition of success and true abundance. The art of abundance is not the art of money making, but the art of knowing how to live. That's a direct quote. So I've promised you, and I will always keep my promise, there will always be scripture. So in Taoism, there is what is called the way. In Christianity, there is what we call God, the higher power. So Proverbs 3:5, trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean on your own understanding. Psalm 56:3, when I am afraid, I put myself, my trust in you, in God whose word I praise. In God I trust, I shall not be afraid. Isaiah 26:3, you keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord God is an everlasting rock. 2 Corinthians 5:7, for we walk by faith, not by sight. The art of allowing is all about unfolding in the right and perfect order. Isaiah 43:2, when you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. All right, so nine life lessons from the Tao Te Ching. There is a website that I highly recommend called Maps of the Mind. And so they are talking about Taoism in this particular lesson. And they talk about the purpose of Taoism is to create a life that is abundant in peace and joy and effortless living. Verse 54 of the Tao says, that which is well planted in the Tao cannot be uprooted. They talk about three traits of the sage. The sage is a person of elevated wisdom and understanding. He knows how to live life free of emotional resistance. So the three traits are humility, moderation, and compassion. Humility is the key to power. He admits that there are imperfections. They recognize that they don't know anything, know everything, and they're not afraid to ask for help. It doesn't elevate himself or his needs above anyone. His relationships are deep, authentic, and abundant, and his confidence comes from within. Moderation. Everything in excess becomes harmful. You need to keep your perspective and remember what really matters. The sage stays grounded emotionally, never allows himself to go too high or too low. His emotions come from his center, not from external circumstances. Compassion. Life is a gift, which the sage recognizes. He lives to give back, not to acquire or to steal. He lives from the understanding of universal oneness. He focuses on nurturing and supporting all people and all creatures that are in need. Number two life lesson, don't value what others have. Value your inner peace over possessions. Value relationships over money. Value discipline over immediate gratification, and gather wisdom instead of catching up on the news. That's a direct quote. So the 53rd verse of the Tao Te Ching says, if I have any sense, I should walk the great way, and my only fear would be straying from it. So number three, look inside for life's answers. Verse 5 of the Tao Te Ching says, man was made to sit quietly and find the truth within. The outside world has thousands of distractions. When we no longer look within is when we lose our way. Number four, what you resist will persist. Verse 69 of the Tao says, when two great forces oppose each other, victory will go to the one that knows how to yield. It's not our problems that overwhelm us. It's our inability to accept them and try to find solutions. It's about doing everything we can and trusting the powers that be. Verse 76 of the Tao says, a tree that cannot bend will crack in the wind. The Tao teaches everything is perfect in its own way. It's about submitting and going with the flow. Number five, life lesson, universal oneness. Every being is connected as one great whole. You are part of a greater whole. The sage finds happiness in helping all of creation. The more he treats all with compassion, the more he is whole and secure in himself. Number six, inherent goodness. We are all infinitely good, and the eternal source of creation lies within us. That source will get you back on track when you get lost, if you let it. Number seven, less is more. Verse 9 of the Tao says, it is easier to carry an empty cup than one that is filled to the brim. The less we have, the happier we will be. Verse 44 says, be content with what you have. Realize that nothing is lacking. If you know when to stop, the whole world belongs to you. Number eight, let the inner child out. Verse 55 says, the child is one with the Tao, living with harmony and grace. This is why the child finds eternity within a single day. A child loves unconditionally, plays joyfully, and lives freely. He goes with the flow and he forces nothing. Number nine, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Verse 64 of the Tao. All of our big hurdles are overcome by taking one step at a time. So here's what I know. I'm gonna back up a little bit and just tell you a little bit about what's going on for the last 3 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks. So I was diagnosed with COPD, as you know, over a year ago. I had my first flare on Thanksgiving. You all saw me then. And flare exacerbation, it's what happens. And then I was put on different medications. And then I got another flare that started in late February, early March. And so COPD, you all know what that is, but when you have a flare, you also have a fever and coughing and headaches for me, wheezing, inability to breathe. And so the exacerbation was concerning, and so they put me on a round of antibiotics. Four rounds of antibiotics later, and four rounds of prednisone later, I was still sick. So I'm still coughing, still have a fever, still have night sweats, still had sore throat, very, very sore throat, still had enormous fatigue. And so I had been trying to get into a pulmonologist, but they're hard to get to. So I finally did get to a pulmonologist this week. My doctor wanted to rule out pneumonia. So I got chest x-rays on Monday and they said it's not pneumonia. So that's good. I got to the pulmonologist and the pulmonologist said she thinks it's valley fever because all of the other stuff that's going on, it's just not going away. And antibiotics don't work with valley fever because, as you know, valley fever is a fungus and it's not a bacterial infection. So my hope is that they say, yes, it's valley fever, and they put me on some antifungals and I'm all better. That's what I'm hoping. Because as you hear, the throat is still quite painful and difficult to talk. So back to this talk. This talk is all about abundance. And this talk is all about abundance and trusting. This talk is about allowing yourself to be aware that you don't have all the answers and that you have to trust that the answers will come. So I'm so clear that it's not, abundance is not related to the material world. Past couple of weeks, as you know, I've been struggling really hard with some health issues. And what I came to realize was how much we take for granted simple acts of living, like being able to breathe and having energy last for more than a few hours and being able to sleep at night and being pain-free. These are all gifts of abundance, but also being free from fear, not knowing what the next weeks or months or years will bring. Taking for granted that you can get up and go to work every day, being free from anxiety and worry. It becomes more and more clear that abundance is not taking for granted any of the huge list of gifts that we have. The ability to heal, the ability to find resolutions to get better, friends that are there continuously to listen and support and bring food and reframe your thinking when we get off track, the ability to rest and nurture ourselves, the ability to grow through all of the challenges with a very, very solid understanding that everything that we go through teaches us lessons that we need to learn. I believe that with every fiber of my being. But the biggest gift of abundance, as it turns out for me, is the ability to trust God, the universe, ourselves, each other, that there is divine order. Peace comes from not resisting, not running away or denying, not living in fear. The peace that comes from knowing many times we don't have the answers. We don't know how it will all turn out. The peace that comes from knowing that a power greater than us is in charge. Abundance is the ability to be like water and to go with the flow. The ability to feel joy in a great cup of coffee or beautiful music or the birds chirping or both kitties hanging out together with me in bed. Abundance comes from trusting. There is nothing we can't handle with the power of the universe who lives within us. Breathe, relax, let go. Don't force a solution. Let it be revealed to you. More than anything else, trust. There is a list a mile long of all that you have to be grateful for. Don't take any of it for granted. There is a right and perfect order to the universe. When you can align yourself with that, you will understand the Tao of Abundance. And so it is. Remember at all times, the power is in you. It always has been, and it always will be.